Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make a basic configuration of a MikroTik router. While I was preparing this video, I wrote all the steps on a notepad so you can easily follow the configuration. Also, I want to let you know that currently I am connected to the internet through my Wi-Fi network that is totally independent from the router I'm going to make the configuration. I need the internet connection to show you the first step, which is the installation of Winbox, but as we are on the internet, I can show you the MikroTik router I'm using for this video. The model I'm using is Hoplite, MikroTik Hoplite, which is this router on the PIC. The MikroTik Hoplite has four Ethernet ports. Anyway, we will get back to the router after we start the configuration, and to start the configuration the first step is installing Winbox. Winbox is the MikroTik tool that makes the administration of the MikroTik devices. To download the Winbox, we can go to mikrotik.com section software, and here is Winbox. We can download Winbox. After the download is completed, we can open, and this is the Winbox interface. To connect to the router, we need to connect PC with the MikroTik router. We cannot connect if the router has the default configuration. It's important to know that we cannot connect to the port Ethernet 1 because the port Ethernet 1 do not allow the discovery option that Winbox uses to find the MAC address of the MikroTik router. The default configuration do not allow this discovery tool, so we can connect to the port Ethernet 2, 3 or 4. Before that, I'm showing you that I will disconnect the Wi-Fi connection. Okay, I'm pinging the internet and I'm turning off the Wi-Fi connection, so the internet now is down, and I'm connecting the cable to the port Ethernet 2 and to my PC. Okay, I made the connection, so we to the neighbors tab in the Winbox, we can see the MAC address of the MikroTik. Here it is. To connect, we select the MAC address and user is admin, no password, and hit connect. After we connect to the router, the window shows us that the router has the default configuration. We click remove configuration, close the Winbox, and now reconnect with the same MAC address, user admin, no password, but now we do not have the default configuration. I'm going to keep the notepad open so you can see the steps. Now we have completed the step number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now it's time to define the WAN and the LAN ports. I prefer to use the Ethernet 1 as one port, and I make a short description here. 1 and Ether 2, 3 and 4 for the LAN. Also make a short description LAN. The WAN port is the port that is connected to the service provider, and LAN ports are the ports which are connected with our hosts. We have three ports for the LAN, so we need that Ethernet 2, 3 and 4 have the same configuration. For this reason, we should create a bridge. We can name bridge LAN. Then we can go and add ports to this bridge. We can add port Ether2 to bridge LAN. When we do this, the router disconnects because we are connected to the port Ethernet2, and the port Ethernet2 now is part of the bridge. So we hit the reconnect button. So we go and add Ethernet 3 and Ethernet 4 as well to the bridge LAN. Now all these ports, 2, 3 and 4, will have the same configuration. Okay, now it's time to configure the IP addresses. For the one, I have chosen this IP 192.168.151. This is a private IP address, but we can, in this case, I will use as it was a public IP address. So I go to IP addresses, add, and I write the one IP address and select interface Ethernet 1. Then I do the same for the LAN. I have chosen the IP address 192.168.20.1. /24 interface bridge LAN. Now this IP address is for all LAN ports, for all LAN interfaces. After we did this, we can go to IP DNS, so we can add the DNS servers. We can add the DNS servers of our service provider, but in this, or we can use other DNSs like Google DNS, Cloudflare DNS. In this case, I'm going to use Google and Cloudflare DNS. So I will add the Google DNS first and then the Cloudflare DNS. After we have completed these steps in the right order, it's easy for us to configure the DHCP server. We can go to IP DHCP server and then click DHCP setup. We choose bridge LAN and then next, 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 next. It's important the order to be the same as I did, because then it's simple to do this DHCP setup. Now that the DHCP server is ready, we can go to IP firewall NAT, so we can make the network address translation. Add new rule, new NAT rule, change source NAT, out interface, we will choose the one port, which is Ethernet 1, action masquerade. Now the network address translation is ready, so we can go to system identity and we can change the identity of our router. We can do microtik test. Okay, we can name microtik test, apply, okay. We can also add users, We do not want to use the admin default user, so we will add another user. We can name user. Okay, we can name user user just for test purposes, just for test reasons. So user, and the group we want is group full. So the user will have full access to the router. Also, we can give here the password and apply. Okay, and then we can create another user that can be read, and we can make we can name user dot read. The group is read, not full, not write, but just read. So this user can only read the configuration, and we can do the password. Okay, now we can remove the admin default user. We can close the window and reconnect to Winbox, so we can reconnect with the new user, and we will connect with the full user. Now the configuration is almost done. We just need to add the default root. You can go to IP, roots, add new rule, and here it is, the destination address and the gateway. Gateway in this case will be this IP address, which is the other router I have in my network, but in the real life would be the gateway that service provider will give to us. We can add a comment to, and we can write down default route. We can click OK. Now the configuration is ready. Oh, I didn't save the configuration, so I didn't click apply. I will do it again with a comment default route. Click OK, apply, OK. Now the router is ready to reach the internet. We can open the terminal and we can ping the internet, and we see that the router do not access the internet, does not access the internet because we have not connected the cable to the port Ethernet 1. I can connect now the port Ethernet 1, which is, let's say, the connection to the service provider. And as we see, the port it's now running and the internet is back online. The router now can reach the internet. Also, we can try the internet from our PC, and now the internet is back online and we can access YouTube or any web page we want to access. So again, to access the internet by configuring the MikroTik router, basic configure, it's easy. You just need to do these 13 easy steps. You can see again here the So these steps is important to do in the right order, so it's easier for you. I hope this video was helpful for you, and if you like this video, hit the button like, and please subscribe to my channel so we can make another videos for the MikroTik devices. Thank you.